Hi everyone and welcome back. Welcome to my new video. And in this video, we are going to talk about authentication and authorization with Node.js microservices. Okay, so we will try to understand the architecture, what all possible ways in which we can actually do the authentication and authorization with the different microservices. So in the current context, like we already have these different solutions like Firebase, Auth0 or OpenID Connect, all the other third-party authentication providers. So we will try to understand how they are actually providing the authentication system for us and how we can make sure that we have a foolproof system against it. Okay, so consider that you are doing a local development and building a microservices on your local system, then how you are going to orchestrate it. Okay, so consider that you are using Auth0 or Firebase. Okay, Firebase is just providing a user management where you can actually do the login with the Facebook, Gmail, all the social login providers are also there. And there is Auth0 also doing the same thing. It is providing you the store for the data and your users can log in with the Google, Facebook, all the social providers. And it will manage your data for you. Okay, so what we are doing is there we have a front end application in our system. Okay, front end application you can say either in React or Google. So it can be in the React or Angular. User is just logging in with the React, or you can say I have an Angular application and I have configured a Firebase or this Auth0 with this. Client credentials are there and I'm able to log in to Auth0 on Firebase. So whenever you are using these authentication providers, what actually happens is you do login with the email password, or you do login with the Google or Facebook. They will give you the unique token. They will create a user in the Auth0 or the Firebase and they will give you the unique token. That token you have to capture at the front end. Okay. Now this token can be used to identify the validity of user, that user is valid or not, user has already logged in or not, right? So this token you can further pass to all your services which you are going to talk. Okay, now I will be writing microservices, like I have Nginx here. So our front end, this is actually our front end. Let's keep it here because this is the place where user is interacting, and this is our Nginx layer. For the local development stack, I use Nginx to do the routing and all these things. Okay, from Nginx you will be talking to the multiple microservices. So you can say I will say this is a Node.js one. There are multiple Node.js services I have which are doing a multiple different things. Okay, now we already authenticated from the Firebase and Auth0. We have a valid token. Now we can just go ahead and start fetching the data, right? But the constraint is we are authenticated from Firebase but not from our services. How our services will come to know that this is the valid user? So obviously you will be passing the token in each and every protected request, right? In the authorization header you will be sending the token which you received, the ID token from either Firebase and Auth0 or maybe any other third party provider. You got the token and now this token you will be passing to all the other microservices, and in the Nginx you just have a routing. So okay, if the request is coming from, I will just mark it, if request is coming from user microservice, then take it here. If request is coming from other microservice like a cart microservice or product microservice, take it here. And if the route path, Nginx route path is different, then take that microservice here. Okay, these are the different paths we have. Just a logical isolation based on the request. Like, okay, if you are getting the request for API v1, say user, okay, then request will be there. If say request is coming for API v1 cart, this will come here, and if the request is coming for API v1 product or orders, then the request will come here. Now, one most common thing which you see here is we need some kind of a validation system in the application which will say, okay, this user is valid, this user is having valid token, right? We just received the token and we are just passing the same token to these microservices. So we need some kind of validation mechanism so that we can call the Firebase and Auth0 to validate the token before even returning the data. So there can be a gatekeeper service or something like this. There will be one common Node.js service. What this service will do is, this service, every micro, there are two mechanisms. Either you write an API gateway here, okay, and then API gateway will talk to this gatekeeper service, which will further use this SDK APIs, Auth0 SDK or Firebase SDK, to validate the token, the expiry, and check if this token has been generated for a particular audience or particular credentials or particular domain or particular app, because you can get the token from anywhere and you start using it. So we have to validate the token first, the token is valid and has been granted for authenticated user from either Firebase or Auth0, right? So this can be a gatekeeper service which will just talk to these two services. Okay, these are together, you can say, not together, but one gatekeeper service will be there, and before you just return the data, these services can actually have a one middleware, okay, and they will just validate the token from this gatekeeper service, okay. And this is just a pattern. This can be improvised, or what you can do is you can have a gateway here. You can have a simple Node.js API gateway also, you can also construct, and here itself we can directly talk to a Firebase or Auth0 simply from here. Now in that case we don't need this service. Once this gatekeeper is passed, we will just redirect the calls to the respective microservice. So there are multiple designs. This is simpler one, like you just allow the code to go to the service. Now you will write some kind of custom middleware that will validate the token, and here also you can actually do the access control. Okay, this particular role we are getting from Firebase and Auth0, this role is allowed to do this thing or not. So that access control you will be doing at the router level in your services. Consider Node.js service. So you will be checking, okay, this user is accessing a list of users. Is this administrator user or a normal user? A normal user will not be allowed to get all the users. But if this is administrator, allow this user to fetch the data. Okay. So this is how our services is going to behave. So this is a simple authentication authorization mechanism. And what it is talking simply is, how you can authorize your request and how you can authenticate. So authentication, we already give a responsibility to these providers. Now our half of the task is done. Either you implement your own login mechanism through some Node.js service. That Node.js service will have some kind of a token generation mechanism using JWT, JSON Web Token or something. You will have some kind of expiry for that token, and you will receive that token at the front end. Now every protected request, we'll send that token back, and that token we have to validate even before sending this to any particular microservice. So again, that is the same thing. You need to have a validation mechanism somewhere, written either a common service code to which every request will talk and check if token is valid, then only forward it to a particular microservice. Okay, so this is a one pattern or one design you can use, and mostly nowadays we are using Firebase, and these services are all, which are already provided to do the authentication. They are capable to take care of login username password based authentication, Google, Facebook, Twitter, GitHub, all these kind of validations, all these kind of authentication mechanism. So if user has any of the account on these social platforms, he can log into your system, and based on that you will be assigning the role from the front end actions, and based on that you will be checking role at the microservice level. Is this user allowed to do this action or not? Another thing which I talked about is this can also act as a simple gateway service. This can be a Node.js service. So all the validations logic of token validations, role validation, all these things can happen here, right? Even you can also use a GraphQL middleware, okay, GraphQL gateway here, that can also do the same thing. Here, you can, if you want to use the take the advantage of GraphQL, then you can use a GraphQL API gateway, and you will talk to these microservices. Here, you will expose GraphQL schema, GraphQL mutations and queries to the front end, either a React and Angular. This GraphQL service will just talk to another services, and this will also be responsible to take care of all the API gateway related tasks like rate limiting thresholds, and all these things we have on the system. For the simple, you can just start with using simple Node.js service or a simple Nginx. We started with simple Nginx, then we replaced it with a Node.js microservice, and advanced, you can just replace it with a GraphQL API gateway. Okay, that will be talking to all these microservices, aggregating the data and exposing the queries and mutations. Okay, these can be talking to a different database. It can have its own database, it can have its own database. It can have its own database. Now I will talk about the advantage of isolating this thing as a separate microservice. Like, consider that you are just using Nginx. Okay, let's replace this with Nginx. You are rerouting the traffic and all. Now, how can you manage the session also of a user? Sometimes there is a requirement, okay, you also wanted to manage the session because JWT token are stateless. You can manage the session of JWT token. I mean, you log in two times to the Firebase, you get two tokens, and both the tokens will be valid until they expires. But there is a requirement, okay, I don't want to allow user to log in multiple times from different devices. There should be one login, one system, one user. Means at a time, there will be only one active session. So, and we are using these JSON web tokens. We can't expire them. So how can we do that? We have to manage the state. So this is the gatekeeper service we have. This gatekeeper service can manage the session of a token and a particular user somewhere like in Redis. So what this service will do is, this service will actually create a session of a particular user who is getting logged in, and that session information we can store in the Redis. So whenever user is logging into a new device or new machine, then we will expire the previous token. And whenever any request is going on, you will first validate the token, and second, you will also check in the Redis that user session exists or not. I mean, we are actually overriding the rule of token-based authentication, which is stateless. And here we are maintaining the state of the token somewhere so that we can have this kind of mechanism, one user, one system, one login, because we have already maintained the session. So if user is trying to log into another device, we will expire the previous Redis key and we will create a new one. That means new session has been created, previous one expired. So if you try to access the APIs from the previous system, because you are still logged in there, your token is still valid. If you try to log in that case, what will happen is we are always checking that user key exists or not in the Redis, session exists or not. In that case, this is just an overhead that after validating the token from the Firebase and Auth0, you are still validating the user session in the Redis. Okay, that user is valid or not. Otherwise, you can also set an expiry, minimum expiry of 15 minutes for a token. So every time you have to log in some particular time. But your expiry is one day or 2 days. And you don't want to allow a user to log in from multiple systems, then you can implement this kind of a logic. Okay. Now, these are separate microservices having their own database needs, and this can be MongoDB, MySQL and all. Now, authorization is another part which we can take care based on the data we are getting. So user is logging in through the Firebase, we are just getting token. Okay, so in Firebase and in Auth0, you can populate some custom attribute like role. Okay, role and permissions. Custom attributes you can add. So while decoding the token at the gatekeeper level, I should be able to get the role of a user. Once I have a role at this microservice, here using access control at the API layer, I can decide, should I allow user to fetch the data for this kind of a request or not. So ACL can exist individually at a different microservice level. Once we receive the token data from the gatekeeper service, every service will get the data from this and they can decide they want to allow a user or not. Okay, so that's it about authentication and authorization, guys. In the next video, we will talk about containerization of all these microservices through some tool like Docker Compose.